Hello everybody, and welcome to Fallout 3. Yes, well, I bought this game recently, and I decided I must do an LP of this. I played this game for a ridiculous amount of time when it first came out, all those years ago. I can't remember for the life of me when that was, 2007 perhaps, 2008 maybe. But, you know, Game of the Year edition. All the DLC, wonderful. I'm trying to think what else. I don't really know. So I've got all the DLC. I've got a couple of mods on. You know, I had to. I can't just leave it. So I've got Fallout mod on, which gets rid of the green tint in the whole map. I've got a couple of retexture mods on, but they'll all become more aware as time goes on. It's probably going to be a short episode today, mainly because it's quite late at the moment. Mainly because I was having some computer problems today with this disk. I had to recheck my disk or something, but anyway, let's get started. I have not played this game in ages. Nostalgia is just coming. Ah, here we go. Oh yes, loading screens. We all watch this. I remember this bit, the song.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love, and with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of.
I do love that song.
War. War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day,
that was close.
When fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
I'm not so sure about that one, mister. Here we go. I'm gonna be born. Oh. What the hell is a foci? I don't know. Oh, damn it. One of my mods is not working. Yes, I just clicked OK. Flippin' ick. Okay, well, this hasn't started off very well. It's gonna keep repeating, so I'm just gonna end the recording here and I'll bring you back once we're at this point again, so see you in a second. Welcome back, everyone. It is deactivated, so hopefully the message will not persist. But yes, that's a sad thing. Ah, oh, damn it, subtitles aren't on. Let me just change that for you. Is it in display? There we go, I just saw it. There we go. On. There we go. Boy.
It's a boy. A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. A beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been
talking. I'll be right back. About? 1 second. Sorry about that, everyone. So, we need a name. Now, I was tempted to call him Steve, but I don't think we can continue Steve's line in this game. It's just a bit too strange. So, should we call him Gary? I don't know, I've got an urge to call him Gary. Maybe Gary with one, we could have two Y's, Gary. I don't know. Maybe I should just name him myself, you know? I don't know. Okay, we'll call him Gary, I think. Should we put two R's just because we're like that? Yeah. Can you even spell Gary with two R's? I'm pretty sure you can. Well, it doesn't matter anyway. It's 2195 or whatever. So, Gary. Gary Jones. That sounds fine. Gary Johnson. Gary Johnson. I'll do. Gary Johnson.
That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly.
Oh shit, I don't think I was meant to. Oh, never mind.
Let's see what you look like when you're all grown up.
Oh no. Oh my god! Oh, we're gonna be. I'm gonna try and. Oh, this is good. I don't really want to sit around for ages fiddling, but. Some of these are so ugly. Okay, we'll customize this guy's. We'll take a more skinny looking guy. A small. Oh my god! That's better. Oh, I hate this. Eyes together. Ugh. This is horrible. That's. This does not look anything like me. That'll do for now. I really cannot be bothered. Eye colour will change to green because I've got green eyes. That'll do. Hairstyle. Terror of. Oh my gosh. just blast back, it's fine. Hair colour, whatever, it's kind of close to mine. Maybe a little bit of a beard going. Yep.
You're going to look a lot like your dad.
I don't think so.
Oh, very strapping.
I think she's
a big world. She's like,
she sounds a bit funny.
All sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be?
Oh God.
James?
Catherine.
James.
Catherine. She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions. Get the baby out of here. Move, move. 1,000. 2,000.
What are you doing? Cardiac arrest on a leg? Jesus.
Hang on.
I'm a little baby.
Just like home. Come on over here, son.
Whoa, fell in the box. How do I come out of... Oh, I don't want to go to you. I see. E. To grab a box, look at it and press Z.
You can make it.
Teddy bear. Teddy bear.
Just a little further.
Here we go.
There you go. My goodness. Just a year old and already walking like a pro.
Yep.
Your mother would have been so proud.
Yep.
Listen, kiddo. I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. While Daddy runs to his office, you'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit.
Do you think this gate is going to stop me? Ah! Oh, what do you think I am? Some sort of amateur? Open the playpen. Can this baby sprint? I see this book. You're special. This is 5 points to go. We're gonna be a fairly strong guy. P's for perception. It means what I tasted. Nope. Endurance, I think, is a good one. Charisma is another good one. Yes, I will have one on luck. Okay, we'll add another one to... We'll put one on... Charisma. Mate, not. I can easily lock these. Oh, come here, you. Oh! I didn't do anything! No! Oh, stay away from me!
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? There's me right there. Pen you in. Come on over here.
No!
I want to show you something.
Okay.
Dad, it was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that.
I don't know what
all
it
right,
means.
Come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
What does that mean? What does that mean? I don't get this Bible stuff. It doesn't make any sense to me. See, left shift apparently makes you run, but it's just making me go slowly. I like the baby noises. Should we go this way? Okay, we can't. I'm 10 years old now, innit? Wicked.
Surprise! Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Dub.
Happy birthday.
Bloody Nora, my eyes.
He is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you.
Really?
Congratulations,
mother.
Young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official Vault responsibilities. So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000.
That looks nice.
Get used to it.
Can
you
I...
You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Funny guy.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool.
That's very nice. Is this it, or has the real party started yet? That'd be nice.
Such a liar. Okay, if you're so smart, what did I get you for your birthday? Okay. One last question. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak, issue 14, and with no missing pages. Yeah, I found this in a box of my father's old things. Can you believe it? Kind of weird to think about him reading comic books. I guess I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay? Happy birthday.
Cheers.
Oh, man, you got a pip, boy. I wish I was 10.
Hello.
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
This party. What, are you two best? This party sucks. Hey, who are you?
Happy birthday, yeah, Sonny.
Sonny?
Why don't you introduce us to your new best friend?
Who do you mean, Dorkface here?
It's happy time birthday, Dorkface.
Andy, wait! Enjoying yourself?
Oh my god!
Happy birthday!
What a mess. Items. I put on my hat. What does this do? Oh, there you go. That's what it does. So if I want to beat up some...
How's it going, pal?
Just, do you see that? That flipping robot missed the cake.
Mortified about the hat. Simply mortified.
That's quite funny.
Daddy, I told you not to act all official. I know you were joking, but I'm not sure anyone else did.
Nope.
I hope you appreciate the effort Amara put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason.
Do you not like me? I'm a really charming guy. I'm sorry, that's just too self-centered.
I do not allow the fact that Amara is my daughter to compromise my position as overseer. I gave her all the appropriate paternal encouragement, of course, but I could not contribute extra vault resources. That is simply what my position requires. No more, no less. I know Amata understands that perfectly well.
She's only, like, she's younger than me, because she doesn't have a Pip-Boy, so she's, like, 9.
Cool, right?
Oh, cool haircut, bro! Wicked! I'm just... What'd you say? Look at your eyes.
This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium?
No.
Oh, right.
Oh.
You weren't invited to my party.
Oh, no.
Too bad, man. It was really fun.
If anyone wants a tarot card reading, you know where to find me. Wednesday is bingo night. Lost one copy of Dean's Electronics. Baseball game in the atrium. Hello, old lady.
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble.
What
you're
you mean?
Waiting for your present, aren't you?
No, oh,
such
just be nice.
Such a nice, polite young man you are. Don't ever lose your gift to speaking your mind so directly. We could use more of that down here. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. You're the birthday boy. No sharing required today.
Good. I intend on eating this all for myself. What the hell?
How's it going, pal?
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything?
Oh, it's all right. kind of old, though.
Of course it is, just like everybody else's. They don't make them anymore now, do they? That one I've been saving just for you, though. The A-Series is a bit heavier than some of the fancier models, but it won't let you down. Mm-hmm. I bet you could drop a bomb on one, and it would still work. As a matter of fact, I know you could.
Be nice. Come on.
Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday. Not much, but I hope you like it.
What is this? I got a baseball cap.
Awesome. Radical. Wicked.
Screw you. Oh, now I just got pure swagger.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake.
Mm-hmm.
Give me that sweet roll you got from old lady Palmer.
You're only kidding me, boy. Go suck your head, butch. I'm not giving you my sweet roll. Your mom drank up all the ration coupons again.
Don't you talk about my mom, you punk.
No.
You should have just given me the sweet roll.
Ow.
What do you think you're doing? Leave him alone.
He hurt me.
He didn't hurt you, did he?
Yeah, he did. He punched my kidneys. What's going on, Dad?
Are you all right? Is Butch giving you a hard time again?
I should just really whoop his ass. I can handle that pussy.
I'm glad to hear it. Once you start letting bullies push you around, you'll never see the end of it. Come on now. I bet there's someone else out there with a present for you.
Nice
pit.
What is that? You guys
like that? Talk. Oh.
I hope Butch didn't hurt you. You want to tell me what that was all about?
He tried to take my birthday present.
Why, that little? I figured it was him that started it. He's been nothing but trouble since the day he was born. You let me handle this and try to stay out of the way.
I agree.
Having a good time? Jonas?
Happy birthday!
Hey, Doc. We're all set down here.
All right, Butch.
Thanks.
What's Butch's problem, anyway? I can't believe he tried to start a fight at your own birthday party.
What dickhead.
A jerk.
I mean, what a jerk. He's lucky, yeah. He's lucky Gomez stopped the fight before I really hurt him.
Right. That's exactly what I was thinking.
Ha, I know, man. Right, God.
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
His beard is like levitating on his face. Where's the reactor level?
I've had it with you, Butch. Your mother is going to hear about this little incident.
Who's this?
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party.
Yep. Stop calling me dearie. Oh, dear.
They sure did. My, my. 10 years old already? Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers. And now look at you, a great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy.
Okay, now this
Since
is patronizing.
This such a special occasion.
Oh,
do you
no.
know what I did? I wrote you a poem.
Oh, God.
Just for you.
Oh,
I
God.
I hope you like it.
No. Cheers.
Don't be silly. One poem per birthday, that's my rule. If I gave you two, think how jealous Butch would be.
Right. Okay, thanks, I guess, for that piece of crap. Piece of... What the hell is this? Jesus Christ. Overseer's authority is absolute. I'll just keep these... Yeah, just... Where is it? I got a sweet roll here. Delish. Where the hell is this frickin' poem? It should be in the weapons, it's probably that bad. Grey walls, impenetrable steel, suffocation, condemnation. Oh god, what a load of shit. Gosh, Jesus. If only I could drop that crap. Just some trampling. Hello.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level.
I'm not a kid. Can it, Jonas?
You sure are. Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that.
I know.
If you can wait just one more minute, I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
Really? Well, I'm just, pretty sure you kind of just go in here. No response. Where is... Oh, hello.
Are you ready for your surprise?
Mm-hmm.
The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work. So, I figure you're old enough for this.
What's that?
Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work.
Jesus Christ.
Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again.
This is awesome.
You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try?
Here? What do I get to kill?
Easy now. It's only a BB gun, but it's not a toy. Let's go try it out. Jonas and I have found a nice spot here.
Oh my god. I thought that said it all my... I thought that said let's go try it out on Jonas, so I was like, okay. Let me pop some pellets in his ass. Give me the weapon. More. How do I equip this? Mm-hmm. I really wish I had the iron sights more than now. So what do we... Oh, hurry up.
Well, what do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want.
Really? This is so great! Cheers! A shotgun would have been nice.
Couldn't have done it without Jonas's help. You make sure to thank him.
Mm-hmm. I will. Awesome.
Careful, it's a rad roach. Think you can take care of that with your BB gun? Just aim and
shoot. Shit. I'll fuck you up, man.
Good work. That's one less rad roach to deal with.
I know,
let's get
right?
a picture together. Capture the moment.
Sure thing,
hey,
dude.
Jonas, get a picture of me with a big game hunter.
Hey, Jonas. Take a picture. How rad. For God's sake, Jonas, take a bloody picture!
Good work. Let's get a...
Take a friggin' picture.
Happy birthday, buddy.
Thanks a lot. This is really cool.
Hey, you don't turn 10 every day. Now go on and let me see you shoot something.
You take the friggin' picture already. Oh, my eyes. So what am I now? 16. Wicked.
I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take a goat exam.
Goat exam?
No, you've got a goat to take.
What the hell is this? I'm really sick, Dad.
No, you are not. Really.
No,
when I started studying medicine, one of the first things I learned was how to spot a kid playing sick to get out of taking a test.
Damn it.
You'll do fine. It's not so bad. Everyone has to take it when they're 16. I had to, you have to, and so does everyone else.
Brilliant.
And most everyone makes it through without a scratch.
Ugh. See ya.
Take care, son. Now get out of here, and good luck.
Piece of crap. What the hell is this? That's great. I'm sure this will be massively useful. Flipping that stupid flipping going exam.
Stopped in to see the old man. Hey, sport. It's been a while since you stopped in here to see.